From the private sector, to government, to scientific research companies, engineers can be found everywhere. But wherever they work, to do their job well, they need an effective leader. Let's meet our next guest, an engineering manager.
Hi, Gila. Thank you so much for inviting me into your office.
Hi, Mariam. Thanks for coming. Let me show you around.
Great.
I'm Gila Pirmoradi, and I'm an industrial engineer, and I'm a project manager in charge of quality assurance and process improvement at the City of Vancouver, Canada. My particular team is called Quality Assurance and Continuous Process Improvement. In a nutshell, I and people like me help other people at work have less headaches. We help processes become shorter, become less costly. We cannot just say we made it faster. The next question is by how much, how many days, how many minutes, and it matters. We are helping and providing support to all other teams across the engineering department.
So I imagine you have to work a lot with other team members. I'm curious if there's, you know, something that you do to make sure that you have a nice relationship with everyone you work with.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, that's a key piece in our success. Building relations and building rapport makes a big difference, and there are so many things we do for that purpose. First of all, having kind of, you know, informal chats, random conversations,
right,
and also trying to learn about what's the viewpoint of the other side of the table and what are their challenges helps us actually be realistic with our expectations. One of the key skills for an industrial engineer is always to be open to questioning the status quo, not making the assumption that it has been like this forever, so it has to stay like this forever.
So Gila, can you tell me a little bit about this exercise that I have in front of me?
Sure, Mariam. So a part of my job is to train people, and we offer training for the staff, but everyone can benefit from this training. It's easy. It's about kind of tips and tricks to apply in a daily life at work and outside work, so that where work gets organized, we can get access to things kind of, you know, in shorter amount of time, and we are not surrounded by things that are so unnecessary. So the first stage starts with sorting, and sorting means get rid of whatever is unnecessary. Whether it's some files on our desktop or some documents we have to keep in our computer. So there are different stages. It's a game with numbers, and I'm gonna walk you through the game.
Sounds good. So explain to me a little bit why this got easier over time.
Sure. So we had like a progressive effort in there. At the first place, there were things that you didn't need. In the second round, when we got rid of the unnecessary ones, it was actually less items to deal with. So obviously less time needed to actually find the ones you want. And in this round, actually, we put them in a place that would be even easier to access. This grid and the logic applied helped you know, okay, if I'm looking for one, it's down there.
So essentially adding a little bit of structure makes the whole exercise more efficient.
At the end of the day, we want to make the process simplified, healthier, and basically kind of more straightforward. So a great day is when people are engaged, they bring in their thoughts, they are kind of, you know, actively participating in the sessions, and we together are able to rank the problems, issues, and actually get to the point of now what's the action to take it to the kind of improved state.
Gila, thank you so much for having me.
Mariam, it was my pleasure.
Once again, I'm Mariam for Career Trek, reminding you that this career could be yours.